Perhaps you already know what the Azure Cloud Shell is, and you've maybe even accessed it. That's great. Let's kick it up a notch by creating a resource group, deploying a virtual machine inside of it, accessing that virtual machine via SSH right from the Cloud Shell. Let's dive right in. I am inside the Azure portal. I'm going to go ahead and click on the Cloud Shell icon on the top left. First thing I'm going to do is set the subscription I want to work in. Easy account set --subscription, and the name is Gwen Playground. Perfect. Now what I'm going to go ahead and do is create a resource group so we can deploy some resources inside of that resource group. The command for that would be az group create --location is an argument we need to provide. I'm going to say East US2. And then --name is going to be the name of the subscription. And I'm going to call this Cloud Shell Demo -resource group. Go ahead and hit enter. And fantastic, we see some output with details of our newly created resource group. Now that we have somewhere to actually deploy some resources in, let's go ahead and create a VM. I'm going to clear this. And the command we're going to use now is azvm create --name. Here we're going to provide the name of the VM. I'm going to call it Cloud Shell Demo VM. And now we have to provide the resource group. Here's a little tip. Sometimes you can hit tab and it'll autofill the command, like it'll type it out for you. You do have to provide a certain amount of letters for it to be able to properly guess. Sometimes it won't guess accurately, but in this case it did. So resource group, now we'll provide the name of the resource group, which is Cloud Shell Demo-Resource Group. And now we're going to provide the image we want to use for the VM, and we'll say Ubuntu long-term support. And finally, we're going to provide this argument that's generate --ssh-keys. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit enter here. Everything is pretty straightforward here, except for this final argument here, the generate SSH keys. What this does is create a key on the VM and inside of our Cloud Shell so we can later SSH or access our VM right from the Cloud Shell. Now this is probably going to take a minute or so. So another tip I have for you is, you see this name here? This can actually be abbreviated to -n, and this --resource-group can be abbreviated to -g. And these are just things that you pick up along the way, you know, as you explore more commands and you, read the documentation. So accessing the documentation for each command is pretty straightforward. If we did something like azvm --help, we get a listing of the information for that command. So it'll give us a description. AZVM manage Linux or Windows virtual machines, and then we have subgroups, we have commands that we can use, and a whole bunch of information. I'd suggest you take a look at this as you are exploring the Cloud Shell, and each command that you run, just run that AZ command --help to read more about it. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and clear this here. All right, so we have our VM. So now let's try to actually access the VM. That's pretty neat, right? What we're going to do is go into the portal, and then we're going to find that VM. And we have the public IP address here. This would also be in the output of the command, but I just wanted to show you that you have another way of accessing it from here. So what we're going to do is type in SSH, and then the username, which is Gwyneth. Your username is the value on the left side of the at symbol at the public IP address. So it's 137.116.56.148, and then we're going to hit enter there, and then we're going to hit yes to continue connecting. Oh, there we go. Yes. Alrighty, and you now see that instead of at Azure, it's at Cloud Shell Demo VM. All right, any further is outside of the scope of this video, sadly. It's time to exit and delete the VM. So we're going to hit exit here and clear that out. And now we can delete the virtual machine and the resource group. We can do that by using az group delete --name, cloud shell, demo, resource group. And then it's gonna ask us to confirm. We're gonna hit Y, and that's it. Now to verify that it's actually been erased, that the resource group has actually been erased, we can run the AZ group list command and just make sure it's not in the list here. With cloud shell storage and then network watcher, but nothing else. And there we have it. We've removed the resource group in order to avoid unwanted charges on our invoice. And that is it for this demo.
Already we've accessed the cloud shell, created a resource group, created a virtual machine inside of that group. We also accessed the documentation of the AZ account command, and we know how to access that documentation for any Azure Cloud Shell command. Finally, we accessed the VM, exited the VM, and removed the resource group to make sure we avoid any surprise charges. We listed out all of our resource groups just to verify that indeed that demo resource group we created was removed. What a day. I'll make sure to link any additional resources that I have in the show notes so you can read about and learn about more on the Cloud Shell. Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, that's it for this episode of ACG Fundamentals. Go on and get hands-on with the Cloud Shell and let me know how it went in the comments. I'll see you in the next one. Keep being awesome.